Good afternoon all. Okay, from last few sessions we are discussing related to this design of the plastic part. Okay, in that we have understood the concept of minimum wall thickness, then design of the ribs, design of the bosses, then we have seen, I think we have discussed related to the draft also, then gussets. Then we have in previous lecture we have finished the one numerical according to the problem statement how to do the design of a bush with boss. That part we have finished in the previous lecture only. Now in this lecture we will see the remaining means how to provide the radius design related guidelines for radius fillets. And then some undercuts, drafts, and inserts that we are going to discuss in this today's session. First, we will start with the design-related guidelines for radius and fillets. Okay, radius you can say that, or in other word, you can say the design of the corner. Okay, corner radius or corner fillets, and or in short, you can also say that design of the corners only. Okay, now. Okay, this is the these two designs. Okay, I have highlighted here. This design is I have written here. This is the bad design, and this is the better design. Why this is the bad design? Because when you are using means you are not providing the radius at the corners. Then what will happen? This portion. Okay, here the thickness will be on higher side. Okay, sharp corners will be there, and due to this sharp corner or sharp edges, what will happen? Stress will increase here. Okay, at this particular point, as it will become thick in nature. Okay, this portion will become thickest. Okay, this portion will become thickest for this particular part. This portion will become thickest, and it will result in some stress concentration or some sink marks may occur here. Okay, as sharp corners are there, stress will be more at these points. Okay, at here, at this point, and at these points, stress will be more, and it may result in the sink marks. Okay, means whenever we are not providing the radius or fillet at the joining points or then it will result in the more amount of stress, and due to that more amount of stress, some cracks or some sink marks will be formed. And to avoid these defects like sink marks, stress concentration, okay, to means in short you can say that to reduce the stress. Okay, to reduce the stress here, we are going to provide the fillet or a radius. Okay, whenever there is a joining point here, at this particular point, you have to provide the radius. Radius, in short, radius, or you can set it the fillet. Okay, and there are certain rules. Okay, there are certain rules to provide this. You have to follow some dimension-related guidelines here. Okay, already this is explained here. That is, radius and fillets are used at the ribs or bosses to facilitate the flow of plastic material and to eliminate the sharp corners. Okay, this is the purpose of providing the radius and fillet, to eliminate the sharp corners. And why it is necessary to eliminate the sharp corner? Due to the sharp corners, stress will be more. Okay, and also due to this fillet or radius, it will improve the flow of that plastic material. Flow of the plastic material. Now, in general, radius should be at least 0.25 millimeter, or preferably we are going for 0.75 millimeter radius, general radius. Here we are not considering any material or any kind of plastic material. We are not saying specifically thermosetting or thermoplastic materials. This is the general consideration. Minimum radius should be 0.25 millimeter, and generally we are giving it 0.75. Okay, 0.75 millimeter. Now, all the corners, another rule is there, that is, all the corners in the of the molding should be filleted to improve the flow of the material by minimum 1/4. 1/4, that radius should be equal to 1/4 of the P, that is 0.25 times the thickness of that part. This is for all corners, for all corners, okay. But generally here for the as far as your better or standard design is considered, you can say that this is the internal radius here, this is internal radius, and this is the outside radius, okay. Outside radius, this is inside radius, and generally this inside radius is 0.5 times the thickness of that particular part, and outside radius is 1.5 times the thickness of that particular part, wall thickness, okay. This radius we are giving, or we are taking it as a you can say that function of the wall thickness only. Whenever we are giving that radius, internal radius, you can say that, or inside radius, this is the inside radius, then it should be minimum, this is the minimum value, it should be 0.5 times the thickness, wall thickness, and outside radius will be, or outer radius will be 1.5 times the thickness, okay. These questions I have asked in the your test, okay. You can take this reference. That is, inside radius is 0.5 times the wall thickness, and outside radius is 1.5 times the thickness, okay. These points you have to take into consideration while providing the inside radius and outside radius. You have to avoid the sharp edges or sharp corners. You have to avoid to reduce the stress and increase the flowability of that plastic material. Okay, now these are some advantages of the providing the radius or fillets. Okay, already I have discussed this point. You have to avoid the sharp edges or sharp corners to provide the radius. Inside radius is half the wall thickness, and outside radius is 0.5 the thickness. Okay, and the why to provide the radius or fillet, it will improve the flow of plastic material, then it will eliminate the cracking and increases the back strength. Again, it will provide the better stress distribution and more rigidity for particular material, and then reduction in the cracking. Okay, as here we are making it more uniform, and instead of using this thick section corner, we are using a little thin section. So whichever cycle time is there, it will get reduced. As thin time will get reduced, as we are giving it uniform thickness, trying to give the uniform thickness. Instead of using this portion, we are using little thin portion. It will reduce the cycle time. Then uniform density will be, as shape is uniform, density of the part will be uniform throughout. Then it is more economical, and it will increase the life of the mold. Okay, and it prevents the cracking. That particular part, how the cracking is prevented, because the sharp corner will eliminate, automatically stress will get reduced, or stress is very minimum. Okay, due to that, chances of cracking are very less. So these are some advantages of providing the radius and fillets. Okay, now design modifications, examples I have considered here, that already this we have discussed, that instead of using the sharp corners or thick portion, we are going for providing corner radius. It will eliminate the stress or reduces the stress. Then again, the same part is there, internal, external corner radius. In the different diagram. Okay, here this is the three cases here I have highlighted for corner design. You can make it more thin, okay, by taking more radius or higher radiuses. You can make this part more thinner or more thick, or try to make it very uniform. Here, what will happen if you are going too thick, it will again increase the stress. And if you are going it too thin, okay, if you are making it too thin, then what will happen? It reduces its strength. Strength will be less for this part. And here, more stress will be created and cracks formation will take place. And that's why these too thin and too designs should be avoided. Instead of that, you have to go for this standard one. That is internal radius, you have to take 0.5 the wall thickness, and external radius or corner radius, you have to take 1.5 times the thickness. So these are some standard design guidelines. Now, some more design guidelines are there as far as this corner radius or corner fillet is considered. Now, suppose this is your part design. Okay, this is the part design. These two are part design. Okay, if you design part in space, suppose you can say that this is the rib joining the wall. Okay, here sharp corner is there. Due to this sharp corner, stress will created. Okay, these are stress points. Whenever sharp corners are there, it will be stress point and it will increase the stress, and due to that stress, cracks will be formed in that particular point whenever load is acting on it. And to avoid it, whenever this ribs and the boss designs or the sets, these are joining with the walls, at the time you have to select radius you have to provide here. Okay. Here radius is provided. In this part, if this part design radius is not provided, sharp corners are there, it will result in more stress concentration. Okay. And to avoid this stress concentration, here whenever a rib is joining or boss is joining to the wall, then, here you have to provide a fillet, and its minimum radius should be 0.25 times the wall thickness. Okay, 0.25 times the wall thickness, that is the minimum that you have to provide. Okay. In this way, this design is modified in this one, providing the fillet. Okay, under that fillet, our that radius will be 0.25 times, or you can say that minimum you can. Minimum 0.25 millimeter also you have to consider. Minimum values 0.25 millimeter, and otherwise you can also, depending on the material, you can take it as a percentage of the wall thickness. Okay, now this is the next design here also. Okay, second design I have considered here. Here some sharp corners are there at this point, at this point, at this point, and here also. So sharp corners are here there. And these will act as stress points. Okay, stress concentration will occur here, and cracks will be created. To avoid this, here a radius is provided. Okay, in this way, this design is modified in a better design. In this way, okay. Due this by providing this corner, what will happen? It will eliminate this stress points also, and it will increase the flow characteristics of the plastic material. Okay, these are the benefits, and it will reduce the cycle time of the process, and it will reduce the cost of the process also. These are some advantages there, and in this way, we are using these design guidelines for providing the radius and fillets. Now you can draw this design guidelines for radius and fillets, or simply for design guidelines for corners. I'll wait for 1 minute here. Please draw these diagrams. How to do the modification as per our design guidelines. Okay. those who have joined late, please mention your roll number in the chat box for your attendance purpose. Okay, then we'll move towards the next. Okay, design of the draft or paper. Okay, and these are some guidelines I have collected. Some diagrams are there. Okay, so these are some design guidelines that we have to follow while providing the draft or paper. Okay, I think this draft or paper we have discussed related to the in case of the ribs or bosses. Okay, but now we will see in general how this paper or draft is necessary. What is the paper or draft? Okay, this paper or a draft is slight angle. Okay, just slight angle in a mold wall. And why we are providing this paper or a draft? This paper or a draft is provided to facilitate, in short, you can say that, for easy removal of the you can say that for easy removal of molded part from the mold. That's why we are providing the taper or draft. It is nothing but a slight angle in the mold wall, whichever mold walls we are designing, and that we are providing slight angle. And why it is provided? For easy removal of the molded part from the mold or from the mold cavity, we are providing these drafts or papers. Now, on which surfaces we have to provide this paper or draft? So you have to take one point into consideration, or you have to remember this rule, that this paper or draft is provided on all the surfaces, okay, all the surfaces which are perpendicular to the parting line. Okay, is the parting line here. Okay, this is it. I will check whether there is a diagram to show the parting line. Mold cavity. Okay, this is the mold. Just take this reference for understanding the parting line. Okay, so this is the mold. Okay, this is our mold, and this line, this horizontal line, this is the parting line. Okay, this is the parting line. This is parting line, means whichever surfaces are perpendicular. Here you can see that this is the draft allowance we have provided. This is the whichever surface, this is horizontal line, is the parting line. And surfaces which are perpendicular to this parting line, on all that surfaces you have to provide the taper or draft. Okay, you can see the modification here. Okay, this is the parting line, this horizontal line is parting line, this dotted line is the parting line. And the surfaces which are perpendicular is first, second, third, fourth. These four surfaces are perpendicular. Hence, we have provided the taper or draft or slight angle we have provided here. You can see here. This is angle we have provided on these four lines. Means whichever line surfaces are perpendicular to these parting lines. On that, we are providing the paper or draft. Okay. This point you have to take into consideration. And now next, okay. These are the perpendiculars. Okay. This horizontal line will be a parting line. These two surfaces are perpendicular to the parting line. Hence, here we are providing the taper. Okay, taper may be inside taper or outside taper. Okay. Taper, you can provide the taper inside or outside. But while providing the taper or any plastic part, you have to take into consideration 3 points. Okay, the molding process which we are using, then wall thickness and molding material using, which we are using for that particular part design. These 3 points you have to take into consideration. And depending on these three parameters, molding process, molding material, and wall thickness, depending on these three parameters, you have to determine the value of that draft or taper. Okay. Now, the minimum values, they have given some guidelines related to that. Whenever you are using a thermoplastic material, okay, whenever you are using thermoplastic material, then the draft or taper should be within this range only, 0.5 degree to 3 degree. For all surfaces which are perpendicular to the parting line, you have to provide a taper of 0.5 degree to 3 degree. Okay, these are some general design guidelines. Then whenever your particular plastic part consists of ribs or bosses, then on that ribs or bosses you have to provide a draft, and that draft or that taper should be in the range 0.5 degree to 5 degree. On each side you have to provide this. Okay, on each side, whichever surface is perpendicular to the parting line, on that surface you have to provide the draft. And whenever you are using thermoplastic material, this draft is within the range of 0.5 degree to 3 degree. And whenever we are using the ribs and bosses, then this draft is in the range 0.5 degree to 5 degree. Okay, so these points you have to take into consideration. These are some design related guidelines. And some more extra information I have added these last 2 points. If possible, if you will try to remember this, these are some conceptual points. Okay, this much description is sufficient. What is the meaning of taper or draft? On which surface it is provided? And which factors you have to take into consideration while providing the draft or taper? And its minimum values depending on the material or depending on that design, whether it consists of ribs and bosses. Okay, now these two extra points you have to take into consideration are like this. If paper is on the inside of the part only, okay, you have to provide the taper on both sides, inside and outside also. If papers are provided on the inside of the part only, then what will happen? It is impossible to remove that part from the cavity if taper is on inside of the particular part. Then it is not possible to remove that part from the mold cavity. And here you have to use the knockout pins or ejector pins in the cavity side, okay, to remove that part. Now the exact reverse case is explained in the second point here. If taper or draft is on the outside of the part, okay, it is outside on the part, then what will happen? Then part will stay on the plunger. Whenever you are using opening that mold, that part will stay on the plunger itself. And here you have to attach the knockout pins or ejector pins on the plunger to remove the part. Okay. Okay, these are the inside, you can say that this is the outside. Here they have given these both designs. This is the poor design. Okay. Here we have provided this draft, then it is very almost impossible to remove that part properly from the mold cavity. Okay, so this is the standard design. In this way you have to provide the draft or taper on both surfaces. Or here we are having two surfaces perpendicular to this parting line. Hence, we have to provide draft on these both surfaces. Okay. And some more designs are there. Okay. Here, this will be your parting line. Then you have to provide these drafts or taper on both sides. Due to this, it is very easy to remove the part, that particular plastic part from the mold cavity. Okay, then this is the second design consideration. Already this we have explained the ribs design or bosses design. Whenever a rib is there, that rib you have to provide the slight taper so that it can be easily removed from the mold. Okay, this is the slight taper provided here. These are the design guidelines. Okay, so these guidelines you have to follow while giving the draft or taper. Okay. You can draw these diagrams. I will wait for 1 minute here. Let's draw it. If you have understood this part, if you are having any difficulty in this design of the tapers or draft, or in the corner design of the corners or fillets, you can ask me. If you are not having any difficulty, you can mention that in the chat box that all points are clear. Then I will move towards the next point. Okay, then as these points are clear, now we will move towards the design of the holes or openings. Okay, holes or openings in for the plastic parts. Now in this we are going to discuss why these holes or openings are provided. Means just what is the purpose of providing it, these holes or openings, and after that how they are provided, means related to their dimensions, depending on the particular part, how we are going to decide their dimensions. Okay, that we will discuss one by one. Now, initially we will discuss related to their purpose. Now, why these holes or openings are provided? first purpose is these are provided to allow the assembly of the assembly with other parts. Okay, one part can be joined with the another part to make a single component, or to assemble different parts. Holes are provided. Okay, this is the first purpose. And holes are also provided to decorate the part. Okay, to decorate the part means so that that particular plastic part will look attractive. Okay, it will look attractive. And some more important function, like means holes or openings are provided, means they will act as a ventilator. Okay, ventilators or small openings. Okay, openings on our doors, or openings which we are using on the, you can say that our windows. Okay, that is termed as the lowers. Okay, lowers, it is also known as lowers or ventilators. Lowers or ventilators. Now, and then whichever holes or openings we are providing in the plastic parts, and they may be of different shapes. Okay, it may be of a round shape, it may be of square shape, it may be of a rectangular shape, or it may be of elliptical shape. Okay, you can provide different shaped holes or openings, means cylindrical or round, then square, rectangular, elliptical, like these different types of holes or openings can be provided in the plastic parts. Now, here the molded holes are having, now here we are going to discuss related to the holes, okay, round shaped or cylindrical holes. Now, these are of four or five types. Okay, these holes may be of four or five types. Here that I have highlighted here. Now you can see from this left corner, this is the blind hole. This is blind hole. This is through hole. Blind hole, through hole. And this is the staped hole. This is staped hole. Then this is the recessed staple hole. Okay, a recessed staple hole. And this is the last type, that is the intersecting. Two hole will intersect at one junction or at one point. This is intersecting hole. Means these five types of the holes can be used in the plastic parts: blind hole, through hole, staped hole, then a recessed staped hole, and intersecting hole. Okay, these are general, you can say that, classification of the holes in the plastic parts that can be used. Then the next point here, okay, one point I have added means this will indicate the some more functions of that use of the openings or holes. Some extra functions mean I have indicated here, that is, it will reduce the weight of that particular part. Okay, it will act as a fixation point, or it will offer a passage, means it will helpful for assembly, and it will act as a ventilator. And also, due to the making of that hole, some material is eliminated. Okay, we are eliminating or removing the material from that particular plastic part. Hence, it will reduce the weight of that particular plastic part. Okay, hence the whichever cost is required of that material is very less, as it means that process will become more economical. That material you can recycle again and again. Okay, in short, you can say that due to the making of these holes or openings, that weight of the part is reduced. Okay, so these are the different types of the holes. Then there are some design related guidelines. Okay, before seeing this design related guidelines, first we will discuss the orientation of these different types of the holes which we are using in the plastic parts. Okay, there are three possible orientations. The first possible orientation, okay, here this is the parting line. Okay, this is our mold cavity, and this is the parting line. This is the mold. Okay, this, you can say that this is the mold, this is the parting line, and this is the orientation. Okay, three orientations are there. This is the parting line, Here we can say that this is the at an angle, hole at an angle to the parting line, then hole parallel to the parting line. This is the parting line, parallel to the parting line, and this is the perpendicular to the parting line. Okay, and the mold is closing in this direction. Okay, this is the parting line direction and this is the mold closing direction. Here whichever directions are they have mentioned, hole orientation, this first is parallel, this is the parallel to the mold closure. Okay, mold closure will occur in this direction. Okay, parallel to mold closure, this first hole, then perpendicular to the mold closure, and this is inclined. Okay, and which I have explained, that is, you can means you can write in any way, that is direction with reference to the mold closure, or you can write the direction with reference to the parting line. Okay, you have to remember that this first is the better design. When this hole is perpendicular to the parting line, this is your parting line, means perpendicular to the parting line or parallel to the mold closure, that hole design is preferred. Okay, parallel to mold closure or perpendicular to the parting line, this is the preferred design of the hole. These two designs will take more cost, or they will improve the cost of tooling, or cost of mold is increased. Okay, this is the preferred orientation of that particular hole, parallel to the mold closing direction or perpendicular to the parting line. Okay, perpendicular, this is the parting line, perpendicular to the parting line or parallel to the mold closing, this is the mold closing direction, parallel to the mold closing, this is the preferred one. Here they have mentioned the word easy. Okay, for preparation it is very easy, and these two are little bit means this can be made it, but some more time will be taken, and this is very difficult. Okay, so these are related to the orientation. Then we will move towards the some design guidelines. Okay, now as for this mentioned the design guidelines, different diagrams I have collected here. Okay, just you have to remember, what you have to remember, you have to remember the diagram, and from these diagrams only you can, you will be able to write these points. Okay, first I will explain these points, and after that we will see with the reference to that diagram. Just I will read it first, and after that we will go to the diagrams. Okay, whenever we are using the blind hole, then depth of that blind hole, depth or height of that blind hole should not exceed the 3 times the diameter of that hole. Okay, so these are some common design guidelines. Okay, for smaller holes, whenever diameter is less than 5 millimeter, then depth of the hole should be, or depth of the hole and diameter ratio should be 2, or you have to use the 2 times the, means whichever depth is there, it should be 2 times the diameter. Okay, now for the blind holes, the thickness of the bottom, okay, thickness of the bottom should be greater than 20% of the hole diameter. Okay, just read it, I will explain it with the help of that diagram also. Okay, for 2 holes, length of the given core size can be twice that of blind hole. Okay, in case of where even longer cores are required, you have to make the tool design in such a way that, okay, balanced pressure distribution should be there. And the last guideline is, suppose number of holes are there, okay, on the same surface, if number of holes are there, related to that, these guidelines are there. I will explain it with the help of diagram only, you will understand it in better way. Okay, suppose this is the blind hole. Okay, from one side it is closed, that's why it is blind hole. Okay, in this blind hole, you have to take into consideration 2 points. Okay, whenever diameter of this blind hole is less than 5 millimeter, okay, less than 5 millimeter, then depth or height of this blind hole, it should be equal to 2 times the diameter. Okay, it should be equal to 2 times the diameter. When 2 times the diameter height you have to take, when hole diameter is less than 5 millimeter, and if in case of a blind hole, hole diameter is greater than or equal to 5 millimeter, then its depth or height you have to take it 3 times the diameter. Okay, means from this diagram it is very clear. Just remember these diagrams and you can make 2 points here. Means when the in case of blind hole, when diameter is less than 5 millimeter, then its depth or height it should be 2 times the diameter. And if the diameter hole diameter in case of a blind hole is greater than or equal to 5 millimeter, then its depth or height should be 3 times the hole diameter. Okay, then we'll move towards the next consideration here. From the opposite side, okay, this is the opposite side. From the opposite side, in case of a blind hole, this distance should be 0.2 times the diameter of the hole. Okay, in case of blind hole, this much portion should be remained. This is one condition. Otherwise, bulging may occur. Means this extension of this hole may mean some loss of. You can say that bulging or swelling may occur. Don't wait. Let that die. Okay, bulging from this other side. Okay, this side. Elliptical. Bulging or swelling from this opposite side may occur. Okay, from this opposite side. That's why minimum this distance you have to keep. Okay, from the opposite side. Then, in case of a blind hole, okay, this is the in another view you can say that for that blind hole. Then for through hole, this is through hole. Whenever you are using a through hole, when diameter of hole is less than 5 millimeter, then height or depth of that through hole should be 4 times the hole diameter. Okay, this is the first condition. And the second condition, when diameter of this through hole, this is for through hole, is greater than or equal to 5 millimeter, then the depth or height of that hole should be 6 times the hole diameter. So this is for through hole. Okay, this diagram is for blind hole, design guidelines for blind hole. Then this is also design guideline for blind hole, design guidelines for through holes. Okay, then we will move towards suppose on one surface number of holes are there, then related to the spacing some guidelines are there. Now spacing means distance of this side wall of this hole. Okay, distance of this side wall of the hole from the wall. Okay, from this wall, that is the this distance S. And distance between two successive holes, okay, that is yes, it should be 2 times the wall thickness or 2 times the diameter of that particular hole. Okay, these guidelines you have to follow whenever you are making number of holes. Then distance of that side of the hole from the wall, it should be 2 times the wall thickness or 2 times the diameter of that hole. And the distance between two successive or two adjacent holes, it should be 2 times the wall thickness or 2 times the hole diameter. These points you have to remember while designing the two adjacent holes. Okay, this is a very important consideration. Okay, then how these holes are manufactured? Okay, this much description is sufficient. Okay, whichever I have explained in the design of hole, means why these holes or openings are provided, and then types of that holes, their orientation, then design guidelines for blind hole, then design guidelines for the through holes, and guidelines for number adjacent making adjacent holes. Okay, and then these are some how these holes are made. Okay, these holes can be made using the mold pin. Okay, here blind hole can be made using a mold pin which is supported at one end, or you can use make the through hole also. Okay, how these blind holes or through holes are made with the help of mold pin. And this mold pin can be supported at one end or can be supported from both ends also. Okay, when it is supported from one end, you can make one blind hole, or you can go it for through hole also. And for making this blind hole and through hole, you have to follow the design guidelines, which already we have discussed. Okay, now depending on the process, okay, depending on the process here, I suppose we have used the mold pin supported at one end, and if you have used a mold pin supported at both ends for making through holes, okay, then depending on the process, you have to follow these guidelines. In case of diameter, it's diameter and related to the height or depth of that hole. Okay, here B is the diameter. Okay, then A is the height. Then depending on the type of the mold, compression, transfer, or injection molding process, you have to take the height. Okay, whenever you are using compression molding process, then depth is 2 times the diameter. For transfer molding, it is 6 times the hole diameter, and injection molding also 6 times the diameter. When you are using the mold pin supported at one end, if you have used the mold pin supported at both ends and through hole is made, then these guidelines you have to follow while taking its depth. Okay, depending on the process used. Okay, then next. Okay, in this case, if suppose we are making the smaller holes, okay, here some guidelines are there. I will explain it. If the diameter of the hole, this is for making small diameter holes, okay, if suppose hole diameter is less than 1.5, then its depth will be equal to its diameter. Okay, if hole diameter is less than 1.5, then its depth will be equal to its diameter. Diameter and depth will be equal if diameter is less than 1.5. And if suppose the diameter of hole is in the range 1.5 to 4 millimeter, then its depth you have to take 2 times the hole diameter. And if the hole diameter is greater than 4 millimeter, then it should be, instead of making it blind hole, you have to make a through hole. Okay, if hole diameter is greater than 4 millimeter, then you have to construct a through hole. Okay, these are guidelines for making this small diameter hole. Okay, if diameter of hole is less than 1.5 millimeter, then depth should be equal to diameter, and if diameter of hole is in the range 1.5 to 4, then depth should be 2 times the hole diameter. And if it is greater than 4 millimeter, then instead of making a blind hole, you have to manufacture a through hole in that particular part. Okay. Then, if suppose deeper holes are there for making the deeper holes, you can go to use a mold pin having steps. Okay, steps. For making the larger diameter, you can go for stepped mold pin. Then for making a through hole, you can use the two mold pins. Okay, two different mold pins which are telescoping together. Okay, telescoping together means from one side, this pin, okay, from this half part, this pin will be inserted from this side, and second pin will be inserted from opposite side, and they will meet at a center. Okay, means two mold pins will be telescoping from opposite directions, okay, to make a through hole. Okay, in this way also a through hole can be made with the help of two mold pins from opposite in direction, okay, on two sides. Or you can use the two mold pins by joining them together or butting them together, butted together. Okay, this is the mold pin, and one care you have to take, that is the difference in their diameter should be minimum 0.4 millimeter. In this way also you can make the through hole. Okay, through hole. and it is staked through hole having different diameters. Two mold pins having different diameters are butted together and they are used to make a through hole. Okay, so in this way we have completed this design related guidelines of making different types of the holes. Okay, this is a with the help of two mold pins having different diameters butted together to make a staked hole. Then this is the hole molded by two mold pins telescoping from opposite directions. Then larger or deeper holes with the help of staked mold pin in small diameter holes. Okay, then this is here one slenderness ratio concept is used. The slenderness ratio is nothing but a ratio of a mean diameter. Okay, diameter to the length. Diameter to length is considered as slenderness ratio. Okay, they may ask this question in the objectives. Okay, in this way, in today's session, we have completed this design guidelines for making corners or a radius or fillets, then design guidelines for making tapers or drafts, and design guidelines for making holes or opening in the plastic parts. Okay, in this way we have completed this. And okay, and already in the previous session I have shared the test. You can solve this test today, or you can solve it also tomorrow. You can solve it also. It will be active for two more days. Okay, in next session only design of this undercut insert, and I will take that MCQs in the tomorrow session, and you can solve the MCQ test. Okay, I have given two attempts for that MCQ test. Okay, I will take the MCQs in next session, and after that you can attempt that fourth test. Okay, already I have shared it in the yesterday session. Please solve it now. Only you can also solve it, because whichever part I have finished on that questions will be there. Okay, so thank you for attending this session. I will stop here. Okay, and after taking the tomorrow session, this first section will be completed. Okay, already numerical part is over. Only some small part MCQ questions and some mold material is remained, that I will take in the next session. Thank you for attending this session. You can continue with your remaining timetable.